We're going to get ready to talk about combining like terms. So before doing that, I'm just going to go over what a term is and what a coefficient is. So a term is a number, a variable, or a product or quotient of numbers and variables. So for example, 23, that's actually just a number, right? And let's see, down here the fourth one I have m, that's just a variable. And the rest of these are either products or quotients with some numbers and or variables. So I have 14x, that's a product, for instance, of 14, which is a number, and x, which is a variable. For 9y squared over 5n, I have a quotient here, right, because of the fraction bar. And in the numerator, I also have a product of 9, the number, with y squared, a variable. And I've got 5n. And you could have more than one variable. For instance, I could make this 5n, let's say, s, if I wanted, or 5nt, or I could have 5nst. You could have lots of variables together, just one variable, no variables, etc. And the last one also, I happen to have a numerical part, which is the called the coefficient, the number, which is negative 2 times the x squared y, again, a product. If you have only a number, as in 23, this is called a constant, because 23 is constantly 23 and it doesn't ever change, unlike a variable which might represent a different number in every single problem. And in fact, we can call that a constant term. So you can call that a constant, but if you say identify the constant term in some expression we're going to be doing, we would say 23 in this case would be called the constant term. 14x, this is made up of a number 14. We're going to call 14 the numerical coefficient. So if you have a number associated with some variables, the number that's being multiplied is called the numerical coefficient. Now we usually just use the word coefficient. All right, let's look at the next one. Notice you've got a 9y squared over 5n squared t. 9/5 is the numerical coefficient here. Let's look at m. You don't see anything in front of it. There's always a numerical coefficient, and in this case, it would be 1, because 1 times n is the same thing. So 1m would be the variable coefficient. I'm sorry, the numerical coefficient. And negative 2 is the numerical coefficient. So we have these numerical coefficients. So what's the other part called? If you don't have just a number, that means you've got some variables. We also have the variable parts. So I'm going to write out, first of all, that's the constant term. The variable parts for these problems here will just be the x. The variable part here will be y squared over nst. The variable part here is called the m, and the variable part here is called the x squared y. All right? So anytime you have a term that has both variables, if it has any variable at all, there's always a numerical coefficient and a variable part. If it's just a number, it's just called a constant or a constant term. All right, let's look at four terms. Okay, these four terms here, and see if you can name the coefficient and the variable part of each. So put it on pause and see if you could fill out this chart for each of the four of them. All right, let's go through and do the coefficients first. So for the first one, the coefficient is 23. It's just the numerical part, the number part. Now, you don't see anything here for y cubed z, so remember that means you can think of it as a 1 being in front. So the coefficient here is a 1. All right, let's look at the third one, negative 4 over x. All right, all there is a negative and a 4. There's nothing in the denominator, so the coefficient is negative 4. And here again is a little bit tricky one. The fourth one, you see a 5 in the denominator, so it's a fraction. So again, you have to think about that as being a 1 in the numerator so that the coefficient is 1/5. This means you could write this as 1/5 times PQ over N. I'll explain that in a second. Let's do the variable part. All right, for the first one, the variable part is the rest of it, right? Everything that's not the coefficient. So I've got y cubed z. We've got, now this again is tricky. There's an x, but it's in the denominator. So the variable part is actually 1 over x. It's not just x. If the x was in the numerator, it would be x. And for the last one, we've got the 1/5, so the variable part is what's left, pq over n. So what this means is all of these problems can be thought of as 23 times m to the 4th, 1 times y cubed z, negative 4 times 1 over x, and 1/5 times pq over n. And if you just use your rules for fractions, you would get what I had over here originally. And of course, you don't have to write the ones that I have with in red, because that's just showing you the coefficients there. Okay, we're going to go on to variable expressions in the first. So just to back up here, remember this first one, 23, was called a constant term. These other four right here were called variable terms. I don't think you're going to be able to see all that. Variable terms, because they contain variables. So all of these four after the 23, these are all variable terms, or without the coefficients, they're also variable terms. So if it has a variables at all, then they're called variable terms. If there's only a number and nothing else, it's called a constant term. A variable expression contains one or more variable terms added or subtracted. So here's three possibilities. 5x plus 8y minus 6. This contains three variable terms. And what's tricky, if I ask you what the terms are, we're, instead of thinking of this as minus 6, we're going to think of them as really being added together as a plus and negative 6. So if I were going to write down the terms in this expression, this has three terms. They are 5x, that's one term. Another term is 8y, and the other term is negative 6. So when somebody asks you what the terms are in a variable expression, we'll really take the sign with it. The second one here has only two terms. 10mn cubed is one term, and 14y is the other term. And the third one has three terms as well. 16m, 9x, and negative 13m. So a variable expression, notice, does not have any equal sign. It's like just an expression, and it's made up of variable terms, at least one variable term being added or subtracted to some other term. Often, if I have more than one variable in the same term, I write them in alphabetical order, and that'll be easier to tell if you have what are called like terms. A like term have exactly the same variable part. All right, so let's go on. Let's say you had this problem, 5a plus 3b plus 2a plus a. In order to simplify an expression, you can add like terms. Like terms means the variable part's exactly the same. So notice these three terms all have the variable part of a. You could think of this as 5 apples plus 3 bananas plus 2 apples plus 1 apple. So basically, it's like combining things that are exactly alike. So to do that, you add the coefficients. Now here's the trick. If you've got 5 apples, 2 more apples, and 1 more apple, you've got 8 apples. You don't see that 1, do you? But if you want, you can write a 1 to help you figure that out. So you have 5, 2, and 1. These all get added together. The 5A, the 2A, and the 1A are all like terms, so they can be combined and simplified to say this is the same as 8A plus 3 bananas. And we really can't go any further than that because, you know, we can't just say 8 and 3 is 11 ABs, an apple banana. Nope. We want to say we still have just 8 apples and 3 bananas. All right, so we're going to go on to the next video and do a lot more of combining like terms using this idea. Have a good time. I hope you learned something. Remember, math is